that is. All you're seeing in here, when you look at me and I look at you, is a reflection of light. That's all you are. That's all I am, is a reflection of light. So Abraham saw into the future. He saw the reflection of the light of the future. He saw that day, and it registered. That's what vision is. And he said, position me there. I know what's going to happen. And so when the graves of many were opened, he was there. See, when God gives you vision, what you're seeing is an aspect of communication via light waves. Communication in the realm of the spirit is fascinating to me. Because, you know, we call it word of knowledge here. It's just instant boom. Well, that, you know, what do you think revelation is? Revelation is an impartation of light. Ah, I got it. The light went on. Somebody's finally home. We joke about that, but that's actually true. When God speaks, it's like a packet of light. If you're an IT guy, you understand this. You get packets of information. It goes boom and bursts in your spirit. And understanding comes. That's how we understand in the spirit. Light is interesting. Now I want to give you something. Well, it says here, Matthew 5:14, you are the light of the world. Quit hiding that light. Let it out. And we were teaching this, we've been teaching this in a number of places. Started in February in Lancaster, then we went to the Philippines. We've been a number of places, and people were taking pictures, and they said, it's crazy, but as you were teaching that message, when we took a picture of you, you're so bright, we can't even make you out. It's just light. I said, oh, that's cool. That's a confirmation. That's not about look at me. That's about look at this. His word is true. True light cannot be hidden. True light cannot be hidden. It's evident to all. Pure light has no darkness in it. That's God. Natural light can have shades or degrees of luminance, but pure light, God, has no shades. He is 100% all of that. Natural light is a function in this realm of the sun and reflections from the sun. Spiritual light is God. And we are reflections of his character, of who he is. So Matthew 5:14, we could read this way. You are the manifestation of the reflection of God who is light to this world. You are the manifestation of the reflection of God who is light to this world. You are a manifestation of the reflection of God. And you're called to be light to this world. Light is life. Just recently, one of the places I taught this, there was a woman in there that had been under a heavy burden, a spirit of infirmity for some time, and she got the revelation, wait a minute, the light of life. That's who I am, and it flows within me. And this infirmity can't stand in the light. Boom! She was healed. In Exodus 34:29, I threw that out on purpose. Some of you need to practice that. Exodus 34:29. Now it was so when Moses came down from Mount Sinai and the two tablets of the testimony were in Moses' hand when he came down from the mountain that Moses did not know that the skin of his face shone while he talked with him. Why? Because he was so much in the presence, the manifest presence of God who is light, that he began to naturally in his human body reflect it. You can't help it. He was irradiated. He began to glow in the dark. Literally, this is a dark fallen world. His human body was a dark fallen example of the reality that God created us to walk in. So he was